All right, hello everybody. So, I wanted to show you how to install TypeScript on macOS. First things first, we're going to open up whatever your favorite browser is, or whatever browser you have installed. Here I'm going to be using Safari. We are going to head on over to nodejs.org. Now you'll see a page like this. It'll give you a couple of different download options. You can opt for either the LTS or the current release. Either one of these works. I'm going to say go for the LTS version. That's because that stands for long-term support. So this is the version that's going to keep getting security updates and things like that. It's probably the one you want to go with. If you want to be on the bleeding edge and have the latest and greatest, feel free to go for the other one. It will work just as well. For this version, I'm going to go with version 10.15.1. Very likely, if you're watching this at any point in the future, these version numbers are going to be different. Node.js does a lot of releases, so it's totally okay if you're on a later version than I am. Everything should work just as well. Download it. All right, it's finished downloading, so I'm going to go to my downloads folder and open it. We're just going to click through here. We'll hit continue. We'll hit continue again. It'll prompt us to agree to the license. Click agree. It'll take 60 megabytes of space. That's fine by me. Hit install. Enter your account password at the authorization prompt and hit install software. Give that a few moments. All right, Node.js has been installed. Hit close. We don't need the installer anymore, so just hit move to trash here. So, how can we verify that things are working here? Well, let's go to the application search in the top right corner of the screen and look for terminal. Here we've got our terminal. The way we can test if Node.js is installed properly is to type node, that's N-O-D-E, and hit enter. And this little angle bracket should appear. And we can start entering JavaScript code here. So 2 plus 2 is 4. Let's see, we could do a set timeout. So in 5 seconds, that should display something. There it is. If you want to get out of here, just hit Control C twice. And then you're back on the normal terminal prompt. So let's install TypeScript. In order to install TypeScript, we're going to use something called NPM. If you're unfamiliar with NPM, that stands for the Node Package Manager. And that's how lots of different Node.js-based libraries and programs are distributed, TypeScript among them. So, how do we use npm to install it? Well, here in this terminal, we're going to type sudo npm install hyphen hyphen global TypeScript and hit enter, and then enter our password. We'll give that a few moments to do its thing. And you'll see here it says added one package from one contributor in 6 seconds. Now, it's very likely that you'll see a different version number here. TypeScript, also like Node.js, releases fairly frequently. TypeScript is really good about backwards compatibility, so you shouldn't have to worry about anything you see in this video or any later video being incompatible. If you wanted to be on the exact version that I am going to show you, though, what you can do is go back to the terminal and run sudo npm uninstall hyphen hyphen global TypeScript to get rid of what we just installed. And we'll then run a command similar to what we did before, sudo npm install hyphen hyphen global TypeScript at 3.3.3. When you add that at sign and then the version number, it's going to guarantee that that's the version you're going to install rather than whatever the latest is, which is the default. There we go, we've got that working. So now what I'm going to do is create a new folder on the desktop. We're going to call it test, and we're just going to see if TypeScript is working. It's installed, but is it actually working? Let's open up test. We're going to navigate our terminal to this new folder as well. You can do this by typing cd, which stands for change directory, and then a space, and then desktop slash test. Once you've done that, we're going to create a file named main.ts. All TypeScript files end in .ts. You can do this by entering the command touch space main.ts. You'll see this file appears in the folder. Now let's put something in this main.ts file for TypeScript to compile. So we're going to open up text edit. If you have a particular text editor that you prefer to use instead, feel free to use it. Text edit is just all I've got on this particular machine at the moment. I'm going to go to file, open, and find the main.ts file in the folder on my desktop. And then we'll put in the simplest possible Hello World program and save it. Now, in order for TypeScript to compile our Hello World program, it needs a configuration file. We can create the default one by going back to our terminal and running tsc space hyphen hyphen init. If we hit enter, it's going to create that file for us, so you can see this tsconfig.json file has been created. Don't worry too much about that file. I will be creating a video explaining exactly what it is, why we use it, how to use it, what the different options inside it mean. For now, all we need to know is that we need it there, and now we have it. And to get TypeScript to compile our main.ts file, just run tsc and hit enter. It will find all the TypeScript files in this folder and compile them. You see now we have a main.js file. We'll run that main.js file through Node.js. And see, we've got Hello World. Awesome, exactly what we wanted. So everything's working. If you're seeing the same thing as me, hey, you're good to go. You've got TypeScript installed. There is one other thing I wanted to show you. You can have TypeScript watch for changes rather than having to rerun it each time you change something. So what we're going to do is go back to our terminal and enter tsc space hyphen hyphen watch. You'll see it gives us a little message starting compilation in watch mode. And then I'm going to go back to our file and say hello world again, and I'm going to save it. And you can see that flashed a bit. It said file change detected, zero errors. We're going to open up another terminal and do the same cd desktop slash test that we did before. You can see if we run our main.js, hey, it says hello world again, just like we wanted. One thing that's really nice about this is that if you make a mistake, here I'm going to forget to have the closing parentheses and semicolon, if we save this, TypeScript is going to give us an error and say, hey, I expected a closing parenthesis here. So we can add that back in and save it, and everything's happy again. Very cool, that's it. You've got TypeScript installed. By the way, if you're interested in going deep into learning TypeScript, I've got this TypeScript by Example course that I'm working on right now. You can head on over to TypeScriptByExample.com. Scroll down to the bottom. You can put in your email address to be notified when the course is released. Also, stay tuned to this YouTube channel for future updates. Thank you very much for watching.